1991, everything ended in a very bitter way. My stock was not given to me. Whatever compensation he's supposed to pay didn't pay me. It has become a legal case, and he attributed that it is a forgery affecting my character. Rather, it was a very difficult time for me. I could not comprehend what to do. Again, I thought of going back to village. By then, partly my parents moved to my here, giving away for lands for lease. So there is a difficult time to get back from lease and then do it. In that difficult time, my cousin, a scientist who worked in NIN in Hyderabad, he moved to US for good. He took job in Environment Protection Agency, EPA, in Cincinnati. He's a molecular biologist. He came to know my episode here. You are in great pain. For a change of place, please come to me. You can relax for a while and then you can think what you should do. He invited me. I went to him. I used to travel a lot because these batteries were sold to many countries. I went to him and I wanted to have change of place, change of mind, everything. Normally, in our system, when there is any calamity in the family, we go and sleep in different house. Nidra jayda untam. So, that way I went to him. When I was there, it so happened he was presenting a paper in Geneva, organized by WHO, World Health Organization. He was going there to make his presentation. I took the lead to go along with him, just to spend time, nothing less. In that international seminar, that was intended to discuss about impact of immunization. Immunization means giving vaccines to just born babies. Impact of immunization in the developing countries. How much they could prevent the infectious diseases and how many children they could save, etc. In that summit, two white people were making very derogatory comments, very harsh comments, very unparliamentary, not acceptable to normal civic people. These beggars come with a begging bowl for subsidized vaccines. How long we have to protect these beggars? They don't care about their children. Whenever there is an epidemic, they come with a begging bowl. They don't have their own program of immunization. They don't develop their own vaccine. And they say that they are poor. How long we have to carry this burden? And WHO officials, they have given a mandate that by 1997, every country should adopt this vaccine, this particular vaccine, into immunization schedule. But that particular vaccine they discussed was about hepatitis B. By then, already in use vaccines were BCG, DPT, MMR. MMR means measles, mumps, rubella. DPT is diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus. And BCG for TB. So, 7 vaccines were there. This one was not used by some of the developing countries, including India. The other countries are neighboring countries, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Nepal, etc., etc. India, relatively more advanced country by economy, by education, by knowledge. It is a evolved society, but still India could not use it. That was their main crunch. In such situation, sorry, the comments were very harsh. My cousin, when I asked him, what is this nonsense? Why are you here? He justified their comments saying that, why did I come from our motherland to this country? the lab where I worked, more politics than science. We could have done this vaccine, but we didn't bother. So they call us like this because we go with a begging bowl. They are talking truth. Why are you getting worried up, worked up? Somehow, it was a pain to me to accept that. Then we came out of that summit over, gone back to US. In those days, communications were not this advanced. No cell phones or even IST was not there. We had to go through operator. I inquired some of my doctor friends here. They agreed, yes, this is an important vaccine, but not much in use in India. Very costly, we are importing that. Only some rich and popular people, when they can get it, they will get it and they will use it. Not all. No doubt we are importing, but very feeble quantity. People with influence, they get it and then get it done. In fact, not only to children, I am a surgeon, one of the doctors said to me. As a surgeon, I am also in high risk group. I am also supposed to get vaccinated. As it is not that easily available, costly, more than costly, we have to go and search for it where it is available. So I used to wear double gloves and go to the operation theater to safeguard me. Then I thought it is something to be done. I came back to India. My first approach was to Dr. Anji Reddy. By then he has a good name and he started Reddy Labs. He has made a history by reducing the cost of many medicines and he created history. IDPL defunct and many people came and joined him. He has done extremely well. I went to him and then told about we are being ridiculed like this, why don't you take it up? No, 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 that is a recombinant technology, you don't know about it. Why are you getting emotional? Let them talk, no, it is not for us. It takes time. I said, sir, you have Ardhabalam, Medhobalam, Angabalam, big organization you have. Your scientists can develop this, what is there? Biotechnology is not there, that's a belief. But my thinking was different. Maybe my ignorance is my bliss. I don't know. My concept is, we have excellent CCMB in Hyderabad. They are doing the same. I mean, not vaccine, but molecular biology, microbiology, biotechnology, everything is there. Central University. They are well known for life sciences. NII in Delhi, National Institute of Immunology. NIV in Pune, National Institute of Virology. So many world famous institutes are here in country and our students are passing and going out of country. Why not we develop here? Okay. How can you say that it is not available? That is not that easy for you. You don't know, that's why you are talking like this. Varaprasad, wait for another 20 years, 15 years. I am not convinced. I went to Intas. I knew somebody there, Ahmedabad. They also had the same thing. A gentleman, Joginder Singh, he said that far away, not now. Biotechnology hands-on experience is not there, sir. No protocols or no system of accepting also here. It is not a simple product. It is a medicinal product. To a healthy baby, we have to give. So naturally, the mechanism of accepting and testing it is not there available. We don't have experienced people on that line. It takes time. You are in a hurry, sir. I think don't get emotional. It will come, slowly will come. We are behind, what to do? I'm not convinced. We have 40 CSR labs under the purview of Ministry of Science and Technology across the country. In each laboratory, at least there are 500 to 600 scientists are there. Highly intellectuals. The problem is in government, a proper authority and proper fixing of targets is not there. You should do this product, you should develop this for the society, you should do this service. Such kind of agenda was not there. They were given huge infrastructure, they were paid salaries, they were given colonies for their living, housing, everything. And they do basic research, they publish a paper, they visit an international seminar, they present there and come back. They get annually promoted for their contribution by way of presenting papers, how many papers he has presented and how many years of service he has, but not on the reckoning of how many products he developed, what is the service he rendered to society by way of any service or product. This kind of direction, orientation was not there. Leadership is not there in our laboratories. That's what my feeling at that time. Anyway, I thought if nobody is doing, let me dabble with it. I decided to do that. That's how Shantha concept has come. We should do it. The concept is, why we could not include this immunization schedule? It is costly, number one. It has to be imported. Because importation was difficult in those days, 91, our forex reserves were very small, hardly 250 to 300 million in 91. Today we have 600 billion or 560 billion. In those days, 250 to 300, just enough for two months of imports. So government was not keen on that. And government was not even announcing about hepatitis B and its perils, like what they did for malaria. You know, for malaria, to educate people, to every household, they used to come and sanitary specialists to write on that when it was, they had given a vaccine or whatever it is. That also these people are not doing, because if they do that, they will demand for a free vaccine. Government cannot afford to import at that high cost. 820 rupees is to be one dose. Three doses to be given for total coverage, protection. If there are three or four children in the family, 10,000 rupees. In those days, for a disease, for a problem existing, they can go and spend. Anticipating that it is going to be infectious, going to be having some problem, nobody spends 10,000 rupees. That was the criteria. Government was also dilly-dallying, and they were not talking about it. They were not creating awareness about it. In those days, and shamelessly, government used to advertise AIDS, have safe sex, wear condoms. Shameless. It is not in our culture. But that also they did, because there is a solution for it. If there is a solution, there is a vaccine, again they would not have done it. That advertisement also not out of our funds. Western society wanted to have safe haven here. When their business people come here, they want to have safe haven. They forced us to take loans to make awareness of AIDS. AIDS program was funded by international agencies as a loan, not giving what you call grant. So there is no question of making any awareness program for hepatitis B. So it is dormant. In WHO seminar, I came to know that 45 million children are already infected, and it is very dangerous infection. AIDS come only through sex, but this one can come not only through sex, even if the same comb is shared by two people. If one person has, he will have it. Same razor, same tumbler, even through saliva. If they are playing rugby game or something, which you have to rub each other, it can also infect. From one person to other person to get infection, transmission, it requires 0.004 ml for AIDS, 0.4 ml of blood. For this one, 0.0004 ml. Even that small quantity is enough. That means 1,000 times more infectious. It is 1,000 times more infectious, one, and not only through sex, it can come through same razor, same comb, same tumbler. And more than anything, they made a statement, more people die in a day because of hepatitis B than due to AIDS in a year. AIDS deaths were hardly 4,000, 5,000 in those days per year. Whereas this one, 2.5 lakh, 3 lakh, 5 lakh people, 10 lakh people. So this is more precarious, and these countries are neglecting it. That is their contention. So I decided to do that. I have no idea. My limitations are, I do not belong to life sciences. My background is electronics. And there is no such a kind of biological product making company, no biopharma company, and no protocols or rules existing in the government. And government circles, they have no awareness about this. When I went to Ministry of Science and Technology, when I went to Ministry of Health, when I went to Department of Biotechnology, they were skeptical about it. Some people were heckling at me, saying that, you want to do vaccine? Oh, you are with background of electronics, you want to do vaccine? Don't waste our time. Don't waste your time also. Health Secretary, only one time he's seen me. Next time onwards, don't waste my time. You are talking humbug. You are living in dreams. Any vaccine in this country was never developed here. We got it from either Netherlands or France. And some of the times we import the vaccine totally. Sometimes we import the technology. We got it by payment. Sometimes we got by joint ventures, etc. All these vaccines, what we have today in use, are developed outside the country. No single vaccine was ever developed here. And you want to rewrite the history? That kind of thing, and they were not encouraging. But I decided to do something. Luckily, at that time, a good Samaritan in the name of Malla Reddy, Usman University Vice Chancellor, we had Sahiti Sambandham. He likes all Telugu literature, poetry, etc. In the morning walk, I used to live at that time in Lalitanagar, Jami Usmania, very near to university. So we used to meet regularly. I told him. Then he said that, look, we have a microbiology department. I will introduce one of the professor there, associate professor. They will guide you. I liked it. I went to them. They even offered, he offered a dilapidated room of 20 by 40 size where they have kept broken furniture. Chair with the two legs or three legs. Chair without proper plastic. I removed all that and then I upgraded it to a laboratory level by having a false flooring and false roofing, air conditioning. And that associate professor guided me to write a project report to Government of India to get the permission to start this industry. I don't know anything. She taught me. The lady, Dr. Geeta Sharma, she took the initiative. I cannot pay her any salary because she is working in the university. So she helped me. We have provided her a transport. That's all we could do. But university is university politics. After 1 year, the other professors and other things, they were not happy with what is happening. Why industry should be here? Whenever there was a power outage, I provided a generator. It used to make a lot of noise, but power used to be there. When power is out, they were relaxing, sitting, enjoying, talking to each other. But when I provided a generator, they had to work. They were not happy, I think. I don't know. But they made a complaint to, sir, why industry we should anchor? It is not our job. And she is not taking enough classes. She is only spending time there. About the other. I recognized, and Malla Reddy Garu also recognized. Varaprasad, I have given you shelter for 1 year. Your team of 7 people, I recruited 6 people. That recruitment also was done by Geeta Sharma, along with me. I don't know the life sciences to interview anybody. At the time, what happened is, I took list of alumni who studied microbiology in Usmania. They are all right outside the country. I wrote letters to them, a patriotic letter. You studied here. You got your degree. And you didn't serve the country back. You've gone out. To get your MSc degree or PhD in this science, you might have spent 1 lakh rupees or 2 lakh rupees. But government or through university, taxpayers' money was spent on you 10 lakhs, 10 times. Remember that. And you owe something to back to the society. But instead of that, instead of paying back, you are still expecting something from India. Whenever I come to your country on a visit, my cousins and other people who studied here and gone there and settled happily, bring Polaroid sweets. We bring Nalli Pattu Pavada, my daughter having birthday. How long this continues? One flow, one side flow. You come back and do something. We need this vaccine in this country. We cannot be ridiculed by outside people. This country has history of 5,000, 10,000 years culture. Here the universities were there. Many people came here to learn. We have taught, we have given to rest of the world definition of zero, definition of decimal system, calculus, geometry, astronomy. What happened? Now everything is there. You people are going and working there, but you are not doing anything back. Such a kind of letter motivated 3 or 4 people. Three people came, but two went back, one stayed back. 7 people we recruited. While recruiting, she used to see the signs. I used to see the attitude. Because I don't know the signs, I can't judge them whether they are capable of signs. She can judge whether they have enough signs. Then I used to talk to them separately. Science can be taught, sir, but attitude cannot be taught. That is inborn, inbuilt. Whether this fellow has any commitment to his country, whether he has any urge to do something, he has zeal to work something new, innovation is in his blood or not. We don't have technology. Can he do that? That's what my proposal to. When I was talking to them, I could see some people. Even before this, I had to go back a little bit. I thought of getting this technology. I again went to US. In 88, it was launched, this vaccine. 91, WHO reprimanded us in Geneva. So I went and found out from my cousin who has developed this technology. That company was in California. I went to them. They made me to wait for almost 1 week to give appointment. Finally, they gave. Even after giving appointment, they made me to wait for 1.5 hours in the visitor's room. Finally, I met. The first question he said that you are coming from India. I said, yes, sir. Poor country. Okay, sir. I know. But I wanted to give him explanation. We are not poor, really. But money, most of the money is only with 2-3% of the people. I want to say that theory to him. But he is not in a mood. You have enough children, why do you need a vaccine? That really hurting. Still, I could take the brunt. The third insult he did, I could not take it. Even if you can afford to pay me technology fee, suppose I give a quote to you, say 100 million, and you can afford to pay me, I give the technology, but your scientists cannot understand this, absorb this for 2 decades. You are far behind us. It is not for you. We introduced this in 88, just 3 years old. You will take 30 years to come to this stage. I couldn't tolerate. I was very emotional. My cousin dragged me. You are becoming psycho. You and I will be arrested here. In this country, you can't lose your temper. Calm down. I came out. Finally, we started the work with 8 people. After 1 year, we had to vacate that place. He has given me, that noble person, Malaradi Garu, free of cost. The premises is free of cost. But of course, I upgraded that laboratory level by spending around 10 to 12 lakhs. My hunt for money started. My own money is not enough. I asked my father. My father sold some property, not full. In the media, they say he sold entire property and then no. Yes, so very calculatively, meticulously, carefully mitigated the risk of losing everything. And he has given me 68 lakhs by selling some part of the land. I had one cousin in US and 2 classmates. I told them that I didn't ask them money. I told this is insult what I am trying to do something on this. So I am on this project. If you are willing to participate, I welcome you. I didn't ask for money. They understood the inner side of what my urge is. We don't have faith in your project, but we have faith in you. You are an emotional idiot. It is not your subject. Somebody, somewhere, whatever they speak, why do you want to react to that? Correct what you are doing. I told them also what Anji Reddy Garu told me. Why should you do this? They asked me. I could not have done it. I would not have attempted this. But I requested Anji Reddy Garu and he refused. That's why I taken him. See, That man knows what he's talking about. You don't know, you are an emotional idiot. That's what they said to me. Sorry, don't further discourage me. If you want to participate, participate, otherwise forget it. No, we don't want to hurt you. We like you very much. You are a very sincere guy. They started putting money. Total, out of three people, I got 1.23 or 1.24 crores. Total 1.96, not even 2. 1.96 or 1.95 crores. That's all I could. Meanwhile, I was going around all the banks. No bank came forward. I used some influence because I am well known by then as an entrepreneur, Hyderabad Batteries. Andhra Bank chairman at the time, Narayanan. I went to him because he knew my name. He asked me to go and see some general manager. Maybe he instructed him, I don't know. That general manager has a template of asking some questions. What is the present usage, sir, this vaccine? I said, I will find out and come back to you. I inquired all the ports of imports, Bombay, Calcutta, Madras. They said that 1.68 lakh doses, that's all, 1.68 lakh doses. Divided by 3, that means less than 60,000 people are using. But we have every year 2.2 crore children. 22 million babies. Now it is 26 million.
Yes.
Into 3.
3 times.
So it was coming only 1.4, just enough for 55,000 people. I told truthfully this is the number. Then immediately he comes to conclusion. So 1.68 lakh they are importing. Market size is 1.68. Sir, it is not market size. No. That is what the consumption now. In that, 10% is our market share. That is the teaching from MBA students. 10% is our market share. That means I can sell only 16.8 or 17,000 doses. At what price you want to sell, sir? Sir, I made a commitment to myself. I made a commitment to sell at 50, I said. To whom you made a commitment, sir? To myself. Oh, to yourself you have made a commitment. Why, sir? 50? Other vaccines are 50 rupees, 40 to 50. DPT, BCG, MMR. When they are available at 50, government could take it up into immunization schedule. If this vaccine also goes into immunization schedule, has to go to immunization schedule, this has to be at that price, 50 rupees. So without knowing the project cost, without knowing the technology, without knowing how much time it is going to take, without knowing how many people are required, how many consumers are required, what is the raw material cost, what is the processing cost, I made a blind call of giving it 50 rupees for a social cause. It may be feasible or not feasible, we don't know. This also I told him, so you are not sure of what you are talking. If suppose we accept you could, by God's grace, you could do at 50, 17,000 doses you can sell, 17,000 into 50 rupees, how much, sir? 8.5 lakhs. You are asking me a loan of 20 crores. When you can finish it, sir? It's not viable, sir. Don't you understand this, sir? You worked in the APDC, sir. You worked in the APDC, sir. You know, you should be knowing this much, sir. Why are you wasting your time, sir? Okay, Chairman Saab, out of love for you, you asked me to see me. But is it viable, sir? Kindly think on that. Be practical, sir. All banks said the same thing, not in so many detailed terms. They said, sir, your background is not this. We never heard about biotechnology products. A biopharma is not there in this country. Another bank, IDBI. Sir, R&D, we don't give money. We give only for proven products. You go and start steel industry, re-rolling mill. You start a cement industry. Nalgonda, we have so many deposits of limestone. You start, we'll give you, sir. Sir, you want to be in pharmaceutical, sir? Make paracetamol, sir. We will give you the money, sir. It has a lot of demand. 6 companies we have funded, sir, paracetamol. Different brand names, sir.
Did you sleep nights for that last 2 years of meeting these all idiots?
I had. I am very lucky. From childhood, I was practicing pranayama and everything. Sound health. The moment I go to bed, no need of any tablet or anything. I hit the bed, within 2 minutes, you can hear my snoring.
So that is your banking experience at that time?
IDBI, IFCI, Andhra Bank, Canara Bank, State Bank of India, everything. No. Reasons are, I am not from that science. Not for R&D. Not heard of biotechnology or biopharma. And there is no precedence of funding any biopharma project. In government, a biggest joke is precedence. For everything they call precedence. If anybody has done it earlier, we will do it, sir. If you want, if you go and say to a marriage registrar, sir, I want to register my marriage. Have you done it earlier? If you ask. Marriage also, they want a precedence. Where is the end for this? Innovative product, how it can have a precedence? When I applied for license through Professor Geeta Sharma to Ministry of Industry, the title of the application is Genetically Engineered Hepatitis B Vaccine. No awareness in the government, circles in 91. It has gone to engineering department, where they give permission for lathes, machine tools, buses, tractors. That is the level of understanding in the country in 91 about genetic engineering. The entire revolution started with Shantha, sir. The awareness of genetically engineered products, biopharma, everything started with Shantha. Until then, nobody knew about it. If I go to DBT, they know about this, but difficult, sir. It's not easy to do. You are unnecessarily imagining things, not possible. But protocols, when I ask them, we are evolving them, we are developing them, it takes time. When are you doing it? We formed a committee. When I come to know, the committee is of 22 people with various departments and ministries. Very difficult for them to get assembled at one place. Even if they assemble, they say that quorum is not complete, some 6 people are less. The quorum is complete, in the discussion was done, minutes are not ready, not circulated. When minutes are circulated, some people are on tour, they have not signed. 8 months, 1 year, 1.5 years. If you want to kill anything in the government, you should form a committee. That is the end of it. Department of Electronics, they formed. I am from Electronics Department. They killed electronics. What is there in electronics here? Everything from China. So, we don't have protocols to accept the product and test it and give license. We don't have awareness in Ministry of Industry to give license. When I applied for it, first to do 10 million, later we see. That is not possible. When batch comes 100 million, they say you do 10 million. Under them, you should not do. How? They are not aware of it. More than that, before that, when I want to build the facility for this, I don't have any role model to see and then emulate it. First time, trial and error, we did it. Even for that, for getting plan approved, the first person to get, to give me clearance is sarpanch of a village. No education. She is Nishanidar. You can ask me, why did you go to village? The biotechnology products, highly polluted, we don't know. We are not aware of it. Get out of the city by 35 kilometers. Ministry of, what you call, Commissioner of Industry in Andhra Pradesh at that time, it is both combined, Telangana and Andhra, Commissioner of Industry said that, sir, biopharma, not regular pharma. We have to be careful, sir. Some pollution, something may happen in the atmosphere. Sir, it is very highly safe. In abroad, they are in the middle of the town. In midtown, nothing goes out. No smoke, everything is contained. Trust me when I said, we are not, no precedence. Get out of this city. 35 kilometers, we went out. When you go 35 kilometers out, no proper road, no power, no water. And the permission is given by a sarpanch, village sarpanch. And she says that, aadakanta paisalu betti po istha. Sare. After that, plan, permission to start something, sarpanch. Plan approval, first stage is sanitary inspector who sprays DDT whenever minister passes that by. He doesn't know anything, poor man. If you give money, he will do it. such a high technology industry to come into this country, what is the kind of government effort to take it easy? Sir, 63 checklists are there to get through ultimately to produce the product. 63. Most of them are unwarranted, preposterous, outdated. Not easy. So slowly my health started deteriorating. I used to get so much worked up. APSCB sanctions power when I applied for it. When they sanction, we pay money. For what? Minimum commitment of so much of power I am going to use. They are supposed to lay the poles and then draw the lines. In those undivided Andhra Pradesh, sir, poles IPN is stock over, you go and buy in the open market. Where is that available? Why they sell poles? Next door, just so that there is a contractor, sir, he will sell. All the stuff moves there and I have to buy my pole. I have to buy the wire. Road, they don't lay the road. I am supposed to get what you call subsidy. Sir, release the subsidy, I will put the road, because I thought when I moved this far, I will have at least road. Road is not there. Subsidy will give only when you complete the project. I don't have budget for this road, sir. It is 1.6 kilometers of road. We can't give. I have laid the road. When I laid the road, some people, well, for a company, government has laid the road. They have done a more favor. Our own money. So 63 checklists were there, and then we fought. After we gained some momentum, Shantha came to known in the circles, government circle. Everybody started praising it. The star company, jewel in the crown. I have been nominated to several committees and whatnot. A great scientist has come as head of CSIR, Dr. Mashelkar, great human being. I told him, sir, you have to make things easier, ease of doing business. Now our politicians are talking. In those days, sir, procedures should be minimized. They are outdated procedures are there. It is a new technology. Why people should move out of city? No communications, it is an international business. Vaccines, very advanced technology. How can we go out of the country and how can we do this? We all worked together and he made a committee, and then tooth and nail he fought for this cause. He tried to convince government, Babu's, IAS people. Do you know, after 2 years of struggle, we could reduce, I am also part of that committee, from 63 checklists to 61. It is a frustration. That's why now any day, now when people call me for motivational lectures, you should be a real entrepreneur. What is meant by entrepreneur? Who is in urgency, who is always in urgency, no rationale, radical thinking. You should think out of the box, not only all these things. Perseverance, persistence, all these are humbug words. Okay, situations have definitely improved compared to those 91, 92. Still, in my opinion, the new entrepreneur should be aware of these kind of hurdles, but they should not get scared about this. They should be prepared about it. I am not scaring them, I am preparing them. Every hurdle, every threat is an opportunity if you have stamina to face it. Nowadays, people do not have that kind of stamina, because in the education system, no moral stories. They are teaching only maths, physics, chemistry, or biology, zoology, chemistry. They are not giving them total personality. We used to learn so many things in moral class, how Jijabai taught her son, how Shivaji has become a great warrior, how Arjuna learned from Drona. All these things were not there now. Chadu undandi, samskaram ledu. Samskaram leni vyakti ki, sampurnam vyaktitvam leni vyakti, he cannot face all these odds. He'll be scared. So anyway, no finance, no technology available. I am not belonging to that science, and no hands-on experienced people. no protocols to test it and accept it. In pharma products, we have called pharmacopoeia. We have to manufacture according to the pharmacopoeia. According to British pharmacopoeia, according to Indian pharmacopoeia, according to US pharmacopoeia, whatever product you are making, its specifications will be listed in that. We don't have pharmacopoeia for biopharma. That is a big struggle for 2 years. Finally, our scientists have done it. 2 crores is not enough. God sent. Oman Foreign Affairs Minister came in. He has invested 2 crores along with me, equal. I was scared to take him as equal partner because I had a bitter experience with earlier partnership. But he assured me, so look, I am not coming here to become richer than you or anything. I am from a royal family, much richer than you. I don't need your money. I can't be lower than you. I am from a royal family. I have to be equal to you. If your money is 1.96 crores, I will give 1.96 crores. Equal partnership. This is only to support your cause. In Oman also, there are many poor people. You all think that we have Bentley cars, we have big cars, all Mercedes Benzes. But more than that, we have asses to go on. Many poor people are there. I also need this vaccine to my country. He is number 2 in the country. Even studying, he is there. He is Foreign Affairs Minister, next to President of the Oman. He came in personal capacity. He invested equal amount of equity, me and my associates 1.92, he also 1.92. And he arranged 15 crores of loan from Oman International Bank with his personal guarantee. Without knowing me from Adam. God sent. Here, my mother theory works. My father theory works. My mother theory, believe in God and then pray. But I have not prayed every day. My father theory worked. If your intentions are good, God will take care of you. My uncle theory, right. I was nice to people. I was treating everyone equal. My own employees are outside people. Many people cooperated with me. In government also, not everybody is bad. 10 to 12% of the people are very noble, very committed, very nice people, sir. Examples I can give. Shankaran, what a kind of IAS officer. Shankaran, one of the best IAS officers. He was collector for Nellore district. He used to have 2 pens, one for office, one for his own writing. Such a kind of honest person. He used to carry his own water bottle. Never enjoyed government services. After the office hours, he used to walk down. No car. Such kind of people I know in life. G.P. Rao, he is still available, a retired person. Such a honest people. They helped me. Though I had very bitter experience with many government officials, there are 5-6 people whom I cannot forget in my life. Doctors, Dr. Setu Babu. When everybody shied away, when everybody was sold out to multinational product, Swadeshi product, our own indigenous development, he took the cause of Swadeshi. Setu Babu walked along with me, risking his reputation with multinational companies. Medwin, Dr. Ramesh.
When the factory was completed, you were...
96 our product was ready. And then when we went for clinical trials, we had other difficulties. Clinical trial ethics committee, they didn't give permission that easily. They also had the same question. You are an electronics fellow, how can you do this product? We have no trust. Will you take it first? I have taken first vaccine. Not only me, at least 10 people they said. My wife, my just married daughter, my son-in-law. My second daughter, my secretary, all of us took. After 10 days, we went and showed our face. We are still alive. We are okay. Then only they allowed us to give to other people. Clinical trials. Closely monitored clinical trials we have to give and observe how they are performing, whether there is any side effects, side reactions. When it is okay, only they allow the license to be given. Before that, we have to do trials on animals, small animals. Toxicity studies. 40 times dose what we give to a child, we give to that small animal. A baby will be at least 2 kilos, just born baby, 1.7 to 2 kilos. That Swiss albino mice, the small mice, it is of 10 grams, 20 grams. 40 times dose we give. If it dies, we have to be careful. We have to examine why it died. Then we dissect it. If it doesn't die, also we dissect it. We sacrifice. We examine its lungs. We examine its heart. We examine its eyes. We examine its reproductive organs. When everything is okay, pass to human being, human trials. Human trials, Varaprasad and his family first picks, guinea pigs, then only everybody.
Great service, man.
Okay, my luck is I committed for 50 rupees, I did it 50 rupees. My walk shuddhi, not that I know about the technology. I don't know how long it is going to take. I don't know how many equipments are required. What is the cost of the equipment? I don't know. How many years to spend on that? Everything worked out so well, I could launch at 50 with reasonable margin.
It took 5 years time to come out of
it. Yes.
From
92 September, 97 August to the market. So clinical trials was a big problem. Finally we crossed that. Then multinationals from 780 rupees to 822 rupees to 780, 780 to 520, they reduced. Below 520, they could not reduce. They wrote letters to medical associations, Indian Medical Association, Pediatric Association of India. This vaccine is not well tested. You are risking the babies in this country. They sent circulars. Then Indian Medical Association called me, summoned me. Aray, such letters are coming. What is your answer for this? Sir, you should have trust. It has gone through licensing process. No side effects. No, we are worried. Then you go and stop that vilification campaign. In spite of the circulars, when we allow this vaccine to be marketed, tomorrow we will be questioned. Stop that vilification campaign. How can I stop? When I wrote a letter to at that time the company was SmithKline Bisham. Now it is not there. Got converted into GlaxoSmithKline. When I wrote, you are a roadside company. What is the damage we are creating? Sir, you are doing damage to my company, not fair. You come and see what we are doing. Their CEO came from London. Only to, he was curious, how could he launch at this price? He has seen it with vengeful eyes. You are a roadside company. What is the damage to you? And he went out. Then I warned him, I will go to international court. Anyway, their headquarters realized the danger, they fired him. Okay. And they were not at stop, but it is going on. Slow. They were very clandestinely doing the campaign. I went to Drug Control General of India so that he will stop this vilification campaign. It is between two corporates, what is it I can do? He was also maybe in their favor, he might have eaten their salt at that time. I am talking about 97. Sir, at that time, this is what called, when you are in right attitude, things will happen to you. That threat, that hurdle resolved by my sudden outburst of one sentence. Sir, it is not black mark on me. He said it is not well tested. The black mark on you, you have given me the license. So you have to save the image. That worked so nicely. Oh, yeah. Let us compare both the vaccines. I had the opportunity to compare my vaccine with the imported vaccine at six places. We came with flying colors. Their vaccine was giving, when you give the vaccine, the purpose of vaccine is what? It gives protection antibodies inside. When we measure it after 6 months, 3 months, that measure is, they are called geometric mean titer, 425-430 that company gave. Our vaccine, when we are given, 25,000 with the two doses, full protection. Vaccine magazine, an international magazine, authority on vaccines, published an article, the best vaccine in the world is from India, Shantha Biotech, a tiny company. With even two doses, it gives protection. the global market is ours. That has given light on this vaccine, how efficient it is, to the rest of the world. UNICEF wanted us to go through WHO pre-qualification. We went through that. And that gives us scope to export to many countries. We ourselves exported to 25, 30 countries. And after WHO pre-qualification, UNICEF started buying from us. Earlier, they were buying from these big multinational companies at very high cost, $12, $13. We have given to them at 25 cents. 25 cents. Around 40 to 50% of the global market came to Shantha. Big volume. And everywhere, name, fame, awards, international awards, national awards. In parliament, this has become the talk of the town. By Pokhran blast, India has become 7th atomic capable nation. With our vaccine, India has become 4th genetic capable nation. So parliament, they discussed, IK Gujral was the prime minister. He wanted to come and launch the product, first genetic product in the country, first vaccine ever developed with local technology, no foreign technology, Swadeshi. Doctor, it is just coinciding with 50 years of independence. 1997 we launched, 1947 our independence, 50 years. So in parliament, they published a book on this, evolution of recombinant technology in India through Shantha Biotech. And he wanted to come personally. He called me. His office called and I went and met him. Ready, I am coming August 15th. We fly the flag on Red Fort. On 18th, you keep the Muhurtam. I will come to Hyderabad. Talk to your CM, Naidu. He doesn't give me appointment. After several attempts, I know him personally. Through one of my cousins who was a minister in his cabinet. Somi Reddy, Chandramohan Reddy. He took me to assembly in the 0 hour. He made me to meet him. He doesn't talk to me eye to eye. He is looking at S.V. Prasad was his secretary then. What is the project cost? Project size, not even cost. I said 20 crores. We have no time. Sir, Prime Minister agreed to come and inaugurate this. As a protocol, you should be there. Without CM, how Prime Minister can come to? So what, Prime Minister? We are making Prime Ministers. Came out. I informed PM office, not in so many words. Sir, he has no time on that day. I know he will not come, he said. I will send my Renu. Renuka Chaudhary was the health minister. She came and he launched the product. All my difficult times, all the hurdles I have gone through, all the ridicules I have gone through, all the negativities spoken to me was wiped out with her one sentence. Every mother who has given this vaccine to her child will bless you, Varaprasad. In the same spirit, we did interferon, which was imported for cancer patients. Every week, they have to give 2 doses. For 50 weeks, they have to give. And each dose is 5,000 rupees. And that means in a week, 10,000 rupees. 50 weeks, you can imagine. How many people can afford it? They say that they used to say, sir, we die with cancer, not with this monetary. We did it 200 rupees. The same spirit we did streptokinase for heart patients. Whenever there is a cardiac problem, first line of defense is they move to, in ambulance they bring, they say that pay 6,000, they give shot. Before even opening that, 6,000, that will immediately prevent cardiac arrest. We did for 600 rupees. Wow. The same spirit, we did erythropoietin for dialysis patients. Around 14 products we have done. Compared to contemporary prices, they are 1/16th or 1/14th price. And nobody attempted cholera vaccine. We did that. It is a poor man's disease. There is no money in that. Multinational left it out. We did that. In Sweden, there is a vaccine, not cholera, but one strain of that is there. We have done with 4 strains. And with this $1.6, that was 40 euros. Not cholera, total cholera. One strain of cholera. With 4 strains of full cholera, we have done for $1.6. Now we are giving it $1. We built our own facility when we were allowing from Oman gave me his equity of 2 crores and also 15 crores of loan, then at that time a great thing happened in government of India also, we should mention that. While I have gone through all ridicules, everything, what great thing happened is, Ministry of Science and Technology, they created under the chairmanship of Abdul Kalam, at that time he was advisor to Ministry of Defense, Technology Development Board. Their job is to fund homegrown technologies for productionizing, commercializing. They don't give for R&D. You have developed a technology with your own technology, I mean homegrown, they call homegrown, Swadeshi. You want to commercialize it, you don't have money, we give you. Okay. At 5% interest, very low, with 2 years moratorium. I got loan from Oman Bank also, 15 crores, at what percentage, you know, LIBOR plus 1.5%. And that means 4.5%. At that time in India, if any bank would have given to me, 19.5%. Lucky they didn't give me. They have shunted me out, saying that God has given them that alochana. Okay, let this fellow be not be in your net. He will get anyway at 4.5% outside. I got it at 4.5. Sir, my mother used to say, if your lakshyam, lakshya suddhi unte, lakshya siddhi goda galugutundi. Suddhi, purity of mind, when your intentions are good, entire universe will conspire to make it happen. My intention was, without knowing anything, my blind call was to make the vaccine at 50 rupees without knowing what it costs. It happened. Like any other vaccine, it happened. Not only that, when I had to move through the channel of marketing, my production department is ready to give at 50. I have to have marketing people. They are tie-clad, briefcase, flying always. They say our department needs 40% for markup because we have expenses. 40% on 50, how much? 20 rupees, 70. He is going to give to a super stockist. He charges 10%, 77. He gives to stockist, super stockist to stockist. He adds 15%, 85, 86. He gives to retailer, 20%, 110, 106 rupees. I thought it is unfair. First time, not only in product innovation, we did a marketing innovation. Okay. That's, we are the only people who did it in the entire world. Mass vaccination camp, that is the name of that. We announce the newspapers, TV. Mothers, bring your children at so-and-so auditorium or so-and-so school or so-and-so community hall. Our doctors will come and vaccinate your children. Mothers brought their children in queues. Our volunteers, our doctors, Setu Babu, Ramesh, Medwin Hospital, all these people, they volunteered to give the vaccine at 25 rupees. Every city in Andhra Pradesh, every city in Tamil Nadu, every city in Karnataka, UP, everywhere, we covered. Otherwise, we cannot sell. After that, some issues have come. Other companies also started doing same thing. Some traders started doing, they used to buy from us and then they used to give without proper care. And some reactions have come. Some people died. Government stopped it. But initially when we did, no such kind of untoward events. So mass vaccination camp created awareness in the people that they need a vaccine like this. Government, which they have not done. And it was made available at 25 rupees. Some doctors, dispensing doctors, cheated us. They used to take from me at 25 rupees. Then they used to keep in their refrigerator. Outside they used to keep hepatitis B vaccine, only imported. Some gullible public used to go, sir, we need a vaccine for our child. I don't believe in this local vaccine, that is Musi water. I give only imported 500 rupees. They buy from me 25 rupees, they give my vaccine to them, they go inside, take the vaccine from the refrigerator, they give that vaccine, they collect 500 rupees saying that imported vaccine. We came to know that. I myself went to the one doctor in Amirpet. Sir, I need a vaccine. Why do you need a vaccine? Not your child. Sir, I am a doctor. Oh, okay, okay. Doctor, I don't believe in this local vaccine. Sir, I need Shantha vaccine, sir. Because he bought from us. I know that. He's having that. I need Shantha vaccine, sir. No. I never stock that bloody vaccine. It is just like moosey water. I will give imported vaccine, Dr. Reddy. Okay? And he went inside. Immediately, along with him, I went inside. I saw in the refrigerator, he's having only our vaccine. One hospital bought from us at 25 rupees. They were dispensing at 350 rupees. I don't want to name the hospital.
No, even I don't want to.
In doctor also, I didn't mention the name. He's a pediatrician. Sir, many things happened. But intentions were good. The outcome of it, I will tell you in short. In spite of several hurdles, the vaccine usage has gone up by 1,000 times. 1.68 lakhs, nay. Now the usage is 400 million doses. 40 crore doses are being used. And its price has come down to 23 rupees from 780 rupees. And we are exporting to 70 countries. We are donating. We are not beggars. We changed our label. India is a donor. Only one company in the entire world donates vaccines, 10% of its production. And biotech revolution has come in the country. Biotech park has come. Biotech ministry has come. Biotech policy has come. And they overdid it. So naturally, some people are not having jobs. When they overdid it, like it happens. Herd mentality, everybody got into that. Parents paid 1 lakh, 2 lakh admission fee for biotechnology course. And everywhere biotech students. Where are the industries? Not so many. But biotech revolution has come. And today, in the world, biotech sales, the fourth largest country is India, 5 billion. When I started, zero. 1997 to 2019, what a change. And many companies have come. The confidence level of our scientists has gone up. We have created a platform for recombinant technology. Everybody has stamina, hope, and confidence that we also can do. Everybody started. Until then, nobody started. Anji Reddy would have started with all his might and power. He would have easily started. But somebody has to take the lead. When somebody did, everybody followed. I have definitely not done due justice to my family because I was totally involved, engrossed in this. While I was in government service also, because of the social consciousness, what my uncle taught me, my mama, I was spending more time. See, for example, DLRL only 5 days a week. Saturday, Sunday, no work. But I used to go on Saturday also, Sunday also. To my marriage, when it was separate Andhra movement, 73 February, separate Andhra movement, no trains were running. I went by Mulakat for some distance in a tractor and then by a train. And then within 2.5 days, I came back to join the duty. I never applied for casual leaves or anything. So naturally, I have not spent much time with my family. My wife is my relative, my cousin, my father's sister's daughter. She cooperated with me grudgingly or ungrudgingly, whatever it is. I don't want to go into details. But she accepted. And when I was in this trauma of bitter separation, my partner, they also suffered. They lost their hope. What is this? What happened now for us? But they regained their strength. We are back to our foot. They cooperated with me. Though, sometimes, why all this? That is my nature. You can't stop me. And the moral strength has come to us when people started looking at us that we are the great contributors to society. Then they joined me. Yes, what you are doing, naturally. Oh my God, our family is recognized. Until then, the testing period, they were crossing their fingers and watching at me. This man is mad, but what to do? And I took solace in my music, in my sahityam, and in my social work. Today, my mother is not there. My uncle is not there. They both of them expired here only, in this house. I brought them here. They were with me for the last 30 years. They have become very old. My father expired in the previous house 13 years back. I came here 8 years back. My mother passed away 2 years back. My uncle passed away 3.5 years back. After that, I need somebody to emulate, somebody to follow. Chaganti Koteswara Garu is my big strength of moral strength. I listen to him every day. Every day, when I'm traveling in aircraft, I can't hear. But when I go to other city, I take my, iPad. I have recorded his messages. I have all his speeches. I listen to him every day, every day. That is my oxygen. So he is my guru. Rather, he is my God, no other God. These kind of alternatives we don't have, you cannot stand this kind of pressure. You cannot withstand this kind of stress. When I go to pollution control board, they meet only once in 6 months. There is no pollution at all. In those days, it is a new subject for them also. So they want to exploit at the time. Some officer down the line, maybe top man may not be knowing. When I go, somebody has to issue me the certificate, no? Sir, your case was discussed in the last meeting, minutes are ready. We are giving permission. Give me, sir. When I talk to him on phone, I will send somebody. No, sir, you have to come. Why? Please come, sir. I go there. You make me sit, coffee daavutara, tea daavutara. Sir, any coffee, tea, thagevandi kada, naaku alavatledu. Give me the certificate, I have to go back. Formalities are there, sir. What formality? Sir, we are 11 members. No, sir. I am not that kind of person. I will not give. Why, sir? Are not you? No, sir. I will never give. Oh, you never gave, sir? No. Okay, sir. Tear it off before me and put it in dustbin. Apply again, sir. After 6 months, we will meet and then discuss. Don't I feel like killing them? This is what recently in a ETV interview, I said. Of course, it was transcripted into Enadu very wrongly. I gave bribe also, he has written. I withstood all this kind of stress. But over a period of time, at the age of 56, I got into diabetes. My mother never had, my father never had stress. I cannot say back to them what they are supposed to be told. I gulped all that stress, I got into diabetes. Otherwise, my robust health. Even today at the age of 70, I take a walk for 1 hour, I do my yoga, I do my exercise. I have no other complaint except diabetes. So, my family supported me. My guru, thinking of him, will support me. He is not going and daily consoling me, oh, Shishya, you are okay. He never said that to me. But think of him, I am okay. I gain strength. What you got, sir? Faith. Faith is your strength. Whether there is God or not, according to my mama, no God. But Daivam is not important. Daivi Gunam is important. Daivi Gunam means forbearance, tolerance, being liberal to people when it is necessary to give them something, give it. Get we must to give. Give we must to live. Living without giving is not living, it is existing. All these fundamentals, my brought up by my uncle, upadesham by my mother, of believing in God and our rituals, my Sadguru, Chaganti, my music, my literature, all these things are necessary for me. Not that they are my luxuries. They are essential part of my life. Today, even today, I can think of mentoring any project with the kind of strength is because of these elements. Sure. And I am Ashavadi. I am hopeful of better days for the future, but that will come only when we change the society by educating, by nurturing the new generation. The new generation should be taught morals. Marks are not important in life, sir. Unfortunately, exactly. In TVs, we see 99.23, 99.28. Inflation has come to marks, not for the money. And they never teach any moral. Marks are essential in your life only at one time, probably. One time. Rest of your life, nobody talks how many marks you got. Did I ever say to any institution, I got so many marks? Did I ever bother anybody ask me what your marks are? Your performance, your understanding, your comprehension of the subject. Unfortunately, this marks era should go off. These institutions who are selling their marks criteria, Narayana Institute, Chetan Institute, all these people are making money out of creating this marks syndrome. This syndrome should go. And a society should come with a lot of morals. Viluval leni manushulu kavachu sir kavalsindi. Viluvulu unna manushulu kavali. Markulu unna manushulu kadu kavalsindi. That society should come when we can change this education system. A better society will evolve. Then better things will come. We cannot change these politicians. They are there. They are only for power. They are not here to save us. They are not here to give us a better ambience, better society. They want to be in power. Their job is to be in power. Our job is to create a new society with more morals and values. I hope your media will work towards that goal and evolve good people from the society. One can raise against the wind. Kite raises against wind. You agree? In the childhood days, we ask our friend to hold the kite against wind, not with the wind. So also, every threat, every hurdle is going to ignite your capacity, your capability. If everything going smooth, you don't wake up your skill set. You don't use your skills. You will be very normal, subnormal level. Your intellect will be subnormal. Your effort will be subnormal. But when you are challenged, you wake up to the call, then all the best will come out of you. In my opinion, people should be trained to face the hurdles. Failure is a necessity in life, sir. In failure, we learn lessons. In success, we gather ego. In fact, failure is the first step of our future success. There only we learn. What did I do? What I should have done? You will analyze. I should not have gone this way. I should not have applied this. I think I should capture this point. That kind of analysis, that kind of introspection will pave the way for the next step. That way, everybody in life needs some failures, not the total failures. Out of failures, one should make the lessons and move forward. This kind of thing should be taught to the children. We are not teaching them. See, sports, why sports are important? Not only for the strength of your body. In sports, sportive spirit is important. Out of two teams, one team will win, other team will lose. The losing team should come back to the ground again to play next time better. That spirit should be taught. Today, children, they are TV lo cricket chodadam kadu, cricket aadadam nerpinchali. Chuste saripodandi. They should play. They should be part of that game. They should one time win it, sometime they should lose it. And they should be able to hug each other when they lose also. Team spirit should be developed. If team spirit is developed, accepting the defeat also is a virtue. And in life also, when you get to have some defeats, I think you should be able to gracefully accept it and move forward. This is not the end of the story. Odipovadam, okasari odipovadam kadu, malli prayatnam cheyakapovadam odipovadam. Gelavadam anedi malli prayatnam cheyakapovadame ఓడిపోవడం మళ్ళీ ప్రయత్నం చేయడమే గెలవడం పడిపోయిన వాడు అలా ఉండిపోకూడదు తిరిగి లేచి నిలబడమే కావాలి ఆ స్పిరిట్ చెప్పాలి పిల్లలకి రాముడు ఎన్ని కష్టాలు పడ్డాలో చెప్పాలి రామ హెస్ గాన్ త్రూ లాట్ ఇది చక్రవర్తి సన్ అండ్ సన్ ఇన్ లా ఆఫ్ ఎ చక్రవర్తి హీ హ్యాస్ ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ వెపనరీ విత్ హిమ్ బట్ స్టిల్ అన్ ఎ వర్డ్ హీ హెస్ వెంట్ టు ఫారెస్ట్ ఈ సర్వ్డ్ 14 ఇయర్స్ ఆఫ్ సెంటెన్స్ అండ్ హీ కేమ్ బ్యాక్ Are we worse than him in his difficult times? Amavar Sitamma, she has gone through all that. Today students, with when they get 10 marks less than the neighbors, he committing suicide because parents are so nonsensically, they are talking to them, if you don't get high grade, don't show me your face. They are not showing. Very wrong. Only people who have gone to IITs are good? No, I have not gone to IIT. I have done enough to society and I am very satisfied with my life. I never studied in a convent. I am able to speak to many people. I have done business with 80 countries. My fundamentals are only in Telugu. I am able to speak to you. This kind of self-confidence should be created in the people. A new generation should be taught what defeat is. ఓటమిని గెలుపులాగా స్వీకరించగలిగిన ఆత్మస్థైర్యం, ది కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ యూ షుడ్ ఇన్కల్కేట్ ఇన్ ది చిల్డ్రన్ ద డిఫీట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ టుమారోస్ విన్. యూ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు యాక్సెప్ట్ డిఫీట్ విత్ గ్రేస్. దట్ ఈస్ స్పోర్టివ్ స్పిరిట్ వన్ షుడ్ డెవలప్. సచ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ విల్ నెవర్ లీవ్ ఇట్. ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ ది ఫాల్ దే రైజ్ అగైన్. బంతిలాగా పైకి లేయాలి, మట్టిపిండంలాగా నేలకు అతుక్కుపోకూడదు. That spirit we should inculcate in them, and children should be taught by their parents initially, teachers in the school, and society in general when they come into society. All these things, we learn out of books only 10%. Rest of it, we copy, we emulate our parents, our teachers, our society, neighbors, everyone. If the society is good, we are made to be. Suppose we go to any European country, we stand in the queue. Why? Because everybody stands in the queue. Here we don't stand in the queue. Why? Because nobody follows queue here. You will be an outlaw. You are influenced by first your mother, father, teacher in the school, your colleagues, your classmates, and later your colleagues in the workplace. When you go to a movie, you observe how people are behaving there. Whether they are taking popcorn and throwing everywhere or they are decently sitting and eating, then you also will be careful. When they are throwing, you also tend to do that. So society also influences you. So we need a better society. That better society comes out of, from childhood itself, it should come over a period of time.